A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 10th August, on the front page you have BJP plans grand Independence Day celebration in Jammu and Kashmir. So 50,000 flags will be distributed to party workers, motorcycle rallies have also been planned. And then this is National Honours. So this is regarding the 66th National Film Awards which have been announced. So here you can see Ayushman Khurana, who acted in the movie Andhadhun, has won the Best Actor Award along with Vicky Kaushal, who played the lead role in Uri, The Surgical Strike. So it's a joint national award for Best Actor. Best Director Award is also for Uri, The Surgical Strike director. So here you can see. Best Feature Film is a Gujarati film, Hellaro. Then, Best Actress is a Telugu film actress, Neerthi Suresh. Then here you have many states reel under monsoon fury, 70 dead. So here you can see the southern states of Kerala, Karnataka, even Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu have torrential rains which are causing floods and deaths. So 28 have been killed in Kerala, 7 died in Karnataka's Kodagu. And here you have amid lockdown, locals queue up for a phone call. So this is the situation in Jammu and Kashmir. The phones have been blocked. So that is why the residents are waiting here at government office to talk to kin relatives outside the state on a mobile phone. So they are waiting for hours here to make a phone call. So this is the situation presently in Jammu and Kashmir. Even TV channels have turned down criers. So communication lines have been shut for 5 days now, and people in Kashmir are using local TV channels to announce deaths and other news. Then below you have Supreme Court upholds law empowering home buyers. So this is regarding the central law which empowers harassed home buyers to initiate bankruptcy proceedings against errant real estate builders. So this amendment, you know, to Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code, the Second Amendment Act of August 2018 has been upheld by the Supreme Court. It is the three-judge bench of the Supreme Court which gave this ruling. Then on page 4 you have, at Yamuna, pilot project launch, CM credits BJP Union Minister. So in Delhi, Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal gave 90% credit to Union Jal Shakti Minister Gajendra Singh Shekhawat for a pilot project to store Yamuna floodwaters in reservoirs along the floodplains in Delhi. And this is cancel license of doctors who still conduct two fingers test. So it is said as many as 1,500 survivors of rape and their families have submitted a letter to the Supreme Court demanding cancellation of licenses of medical practitioners who still conduct humiliating two finger test on rape survivors despite a Supreme Court ban on it. Then below you have High Court traps RBI for not replying to plea claiming misuse of data by banks. So Delhi High Court pulled up Reserve Bank of India for failing to give any response from February 2019 till date to a petition seeking to stop banks from sharing the PAN and financial transaction data of clients with credit rating agencies without customers' formal consent. So Delhi High Court has said the central bank's attitude is callous and negligent. Then this is BSES advisory on kite flying ahead of Independence Day. So this is the advisory which says that people should not fly kites near electrical installations as metal coated manjas could cause electrocutions as well as tripping. On page 6 you have Center will not touch Article 371F. So this is Sikkim Chief Minister has cited Union Home Minister's assurance on state special status. So Article 370 conferred special status to Jammu and Kashmir, which has been scrapped now. But there are other articles, Article 371, under which various states have been given special features. So Article 371F is special feature for Sikkim. And Sikkim Chief Minister says that that would not be affected. That assurance has been given, he says, by Union Home Minister Amit Shah himself. On page 8, you have this detailed coverage on floods in southern states. And below you have IIT Hyderabad, Harvard University study mercury accumulation in fish. So this is a joint research which is looking into how climate change is impacting accumulation of metal mercury in fish. On editorial page you have State of the Union. So the first editorial talks about early elections and full statehood as essential for total integration of Jammu and Kashmir with India. And this is taking on the mob. So this is regarding Rajasthan's laws on lynching, honor killing. So these are said to be inevitable responses to rising hate crimes. So this is the need of the laws on these matters. Then this is the lead article, incisive interventions that blunt the RTI's edge. So it says, with the kernel of the Information Act under threat, the independence of Information Commission is in peril. So this is an old issue. We have already seen how RTI has been diluted. The act has been passed by both houses too. So this is the lead article on that issue. And this is not the final word from Islamabad and Delhi. So this is regarding strained relations between the two neighboring countries. That's, it says there are already signs that the Kulbhushan Jadhav case between Pakistan and India might return to the International Court of Justice. Then on Saturdays on Up-Ed page, you have Ground Zero coverage, which is a detailed coverage on a particular issue. So today it is regarding Maharashtra's drought-stricken district of Bid, which has hit headlines recently when reports emerged of an unusually high rate of hysterectomies among its women, especially those who migrate to nearby districts to cut sugarcane. So hysterectomy is a procedure, an operation which is conducted to make sure that women do not have any more children. On page 12, you have every child to get rotavirus vaccine. So Health Ministry plans to provide rotavirus vaccine all across states and union territories by September 2019. On international page, you have again Hong Kong protests going on, and the leader Carrie Lam saying that protesters should end violence and chaos, and she will not provide any concessions. And this is regarding peace in Afghanistan. A peace deal to end Afghanistan's 18-year-long conflict could see US pulling out thousands of troops in exchange of promise that Taliban will sever ties with militant groups like Al-Qaeda. So this is regarding US spending for Afghan war, which is shown here, and number of troops in Afghanistan as such too. Then this is China orders Cathay Pacific to suspend staff backing protests. So this is regarding the Cathay Pacific airline, where you know Chinese aviation regulator demanded that Hong Kong flag carrier, that is Cathay Pacific Airways, suspend personnel who have engaged in illegal protests in Hong Kong from stuffing flights into its airspace from August 10. And this is Chechnya sends former IS members to schools, not jails. So former Islamic State members who have returned to their home country from Syria. So here in Chechnya, they have sent these members to schools, and they share the experiences about the perils of extremism. And this is Huawei unveils Harmony as a rival to Android. So first version will be launched later in 2019. So Chinese telecom major, which has been targeted by USA and other countries, pressured by USA. So Huawei, it has unveiled its own operating system as it faces the threat of losing access to Google's Android platform under escalating US-China trade tensions. So it has unveiled its own platform that is called Harmony. On business page, you have FPI, Foreign Portfolio Investment Tax issues put divestment at risk. So players would meet finance minister, and they say the center may take steps to revive overseas investors' interest in capital markets. So in the budget, when the taxation was announced for high net worth individuals, so former foreign portfolio investors were also affected. And now government could risk missing on its record for disinvestment target this year, because foreign portfolio investors would stay away from such share sales if the ongoing tax concerns are not resolved soon. And this is public sector banks link lending repo rates. So we saw yesterday how RBI has brought down repo rate, and now public sector banks would be linking their lending rates with the repo rate. So this will be transferring, you know, or the transmission of this would low repo rate, low interest rate would go ahead for customers, loanees. So this is to bid to aid faster monetary transmission. So faster monetary transmission means when RBI reduces interest rate, in the markets also interest rates should go down. So that transmission will happen now. And this is IIP, that is Index of Industrial Production Growth, slips to 4-month low. So manufacturing has slowed down, consumer durables, capital goods have shrunk specifically. So you can see IIP is at 4-month low. Then below you have CSE's target 1 lakh EV charging stations. So that is electric vehicle charging stations. So this is common service centers which come under Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. They plan to open 1 lakh charging stations for electric vehicles across the country in the next few years. So this is, it says with village level entrepreneurs participation will be larger than Indian Oil Corporation. Then there's sports coverage on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.